Much, my brothers and my sisters. A round of applause for Brother John Victorine. And tonight, what I saw was a man with a conscience, a man with commitment, a man who feels the pain of his people. A man who wants to improve the quality of life of the people of Anzuri and Canaries. A man who is not in politics to defend anybody's interests, but a man in politics for the interests of the people. That is what I saw in John Victorine. I am very proud. I am very proud to be on the platform with John Victorine tonight. Because in John Victorine, you have a representative who will give you quality representation under the St. Lucia Labour Party. And I want to thank Dr. Desmond Long, because Dr. Desmond Long represented you for 5 years, and he has willingly handed the baton over to John Victorine. Thank you very much, Dr. Desmond Long. My brothers and my sisters, tonight is a very important night for Labour. It's a very important night because we are on the verge of one of the most important political battles in the history of St. Lucia. It is a battle that will determine the future of your country. It's a battle that will determine whether your children will have the same opportunity like the children of those who have. It's a battle that will determine whether economic power will be put into the hands of small businessmen and small entrepreneurs. It's a battle that will determine whether your children will have equal and quality education. It's a battle that will determine whether we can achieve and create sportsmen like Darren Sammy and Johnson Charles. It's a battle that will determine whether the NICE program, whether care for the elderly, will continue. It's a battle that will determine whether your children will get the $500 voucher to go to secondary school when they pass the common entrance examination. It's a battle that will determine whether people who can't afford can get their CXC fees paid through the government of St. Lucia. But most importantly, it is a battle that will determine whether Dr. Kenny Anthony will remain as Prime Minister of St. Lucia to continue his leadership and his direction for the people of St. Lucia. So you have to understand that you must take this election seriously. You must take this election seriously. You must vote. Some people are saying, le bon jagain et ma vote. You must vote. You must exercise your franchise, my brothers and my sisters. As we speak, the UWP have a sideshow in Anchipo. And only what they're talking about is Philip J. Pierre. Even Bradley Felix joined the group. I want to tell Bradley Felix just one thing. I came into politics when I was 29 years of age. And I stayed in politics. I stayed in the Labour Party. And I did not wait for anything. My commitment was towards the people of Castries East and the people of St. Lucia. That was my commitment. The same commitment that my friend John Victrin has. Commitment to serve. Commitment to work for the people. Not commitment to wait to see how things run in before you run election. That is my story. And that is the example that John Victrin is setting for candidates like Bradley Felix. Showing them you need commitment. You need heart. You need to be consistent. You need to belong to a party that you share a philosophical underpinning with. That is what John Victrin is showing. So they all my case. Sarah Flood. Even Sarah Flood joined the party. Sarah Flood is a major contradiction. You saw Sarah Flood talking about Alan Shastley. And now Sarah Flood wants to run elections. So she's on my case. But what Sarah Flood does not understand is the people of Castries Central will reject her as they did before and will elect Stanley Felix into parliament at the next general election. So tonight, only what you hear on the other side is personal attacks. Only what you hear is Mepui and Roro. That's all you hear from the United Workers Party. Even Guy Myers called me a water boy. But if a water boy can beat you twice in two different elections, what are you? So my brothers, we on this platform, we do not engage in that roro and nonsense and foolishness of the United Workers Party. We are a party of substance. We are a party that attracts candidates like John Victrin, candidates like Gideon, candidates like Dr. Ernest Hilaire. Like who? Candidates like Joachim Henry, candidates like Rosary, candidates like Gibeon Ferdinand. These are the candidates we attract in the St. Lucia Labour Party. And all of these candidates will join an experienced team under the leadership of Dr. Kenny D. Anthony. Under the leadership of Dr. Kenny Anthony. Under one leader we trust, one leader we believe in, and that leader will take us to victory when the elections are called. So what you hear from the United Workers Party? A lot of nonsense. You heard Alan Shastley say that he will reduce VAT and remove VAT. My brothers and my sisters, when I tell you that Alan Shastley does not speak the truth, you think I'm joking. Sometimes you think that one man cannot say so many things that are not true. I'm sure you do not believe sometimes that one man can say so many things that are not true. I want to tell you briefly the history of VAT in St. Lucia. In two candidates like John Chalery, thank you very much, my brother. I want to tell you the history of VAT, a short history of VAT in St. Lucia. In 2008, the IMF recommended that VAT be introduced in 2008. In 2009, there was a letter of intent written to the IMF and signed by the then Prime Minister. And the letter said, introduction of a value-added tax in 2010 with a uniform rate and very limited number of exempted goods and services aimed at broadening the tax base. That letter was written by the then Prime Minister in 2009. Alan Chasney was part of the government. In 2010, the same IMF mission, the government has reiterated its commitment to a medium-term fiscal policy strategy. The planned fiscal measures include implementation of a broad-based value-added tax, market-based property taxes, a tax on interest income and vehicle licensing fees. That was what the United Workers' Party promised the IMF in 2010. That was what in 2010. In 2010, Alan Chasney was part of that cabinet. That was what they did. And I want you to check it for yourself. Go on the IMF website and check it for yourself, because the government has ensured that everybody, every school child, has access to a computer so nobody can fool them again. Go and check it yourself about the IMF. On the 18th of August 2011, a statement by the IMF mission in St. Lucia, it said, the implementation of VAT by April 2012, the government promised that mission that by April 2010, they would implement VAT. On May the 9th, 2011, a press release from the office of the Prime Minister reads, St. Lucia is therefore one of the last remaining countries of the ECCU that has not yet adopted the VAT. I wish to reaffirm the commitment of this government, that's the government of the United Workers' Party, to its implementation by April 2012, mindful of the socio-economic responsibilities of the government. That is a press statement from the office of the Prime Minister, and it's not Prime Minister Kenny Anthony. The Prime Minister also said, VAT is designed to streamline the tax system and is not intended to be an additional tax, adding, it will make tax administration more efficient by eliminating nuisance taxes. That is the story of VAT in St. Lucia. That is the story of VAT. So when Alan Chasney comes to you and makes you believe that VAT is a tax that the St. Lucia Labour Party put on you, and when he gets into government, he will change it, Alan Chasney is, as usual, not speaking the truth. Because what I'm saying to you is things you can check for yourself. I'm not speaking from my head. I'm speaking from things you can find out for yourself, my brothers and sisters. So the same United Workers Party government, they promised the IMF that they would increase property taxes, that they would increase licensing fees. They told them that in the year 2010. But they did not have the commitment. They did not have the interest of the people of St. Lucia at heart. They did not have the interest of the economy to do what they promised the IMF to do. It took the courage and fortitude of the Labour Party under Dr. Kenny Anthony to take these steps to move the economy to where it is now. And the economy is growing. The economy is growing. We have reduced the fiscal deficit. We have brought investment back in St. Lucia. Evidence for yourself. Ask Alan Chasney, how many hotel rooms were built in St. Lucia when he was Minister of Tourism? These are the questions you must ask him. These are the questions you must ask the United Workers Party, and not the foolishness and the nonsense and the roro and the character assassination that happens under that platform. These are the questions you must ask them, my brothers and sisters. Can you trust Alan Chasney with any five-point plan? Can you trust Alan Chasney with any five-point plan? That was the same Alan Chesney in government when he said, a secure future for St. Lucia, a development agenda for St. Lucia, first term report card. I want you to find that report card. I don't have time to read it tonight. And tell me how many things in that report card were implemented by the United Workers Party when they were in government. My brothers and sisters, you can trust the Labour Party to deliver on its promises. The Labour Party told you, from 1997 that they would bring universal secondary school education, and we did it. The Labour Party told you that we will build you a new hospital, and we build it on the verge of opening it. The Labour Party told you that they would build new secondary schools, and we did it. The Labour Party promised you that when we go into power, because of the situation of unemployment, we would create jobs through the NICE program, and we did it. And right now, through the NICE program, over 5,000 people are employed and working directly for their own money. So they cannot beg politicians again, like what the United Workers Party wants you to do. Because the United Workers Party believes that because they can fool you, because they have a few dollars, they believe they can fool you. But this time, tell them to put it in the pipe and we are not selling our vote. We are voting for our future. We are voting for our country. We are voting for no 5 cents or no $10. So tell them, do not insult the people of St. Lucia. Tell them that the people of St. Lucia want different. Tell them the people of St. Lucia understand who is on their side and who is not on their side. Tell them the people of St. Lucia are convinced that Dr. Kenny Anthony is the best leader for St. Lucia and the best prime minister at this time for this